What's going on, guys? This is the 30 for 30 series. Today we are in my garage and also in the house. It's gonna be an intense workout, so let's jump right in. I got problems on problems on problems on problems on problems on problems. I solve them. I run through the money. Depression be calling. Left on my blessings. I feel like I'm falling. The birdie is back. Tell me I'm garbage. I'm going through something. That's why I ain't calling. Phone in progression. It's all that I wanted. All right, 30 for 30. Today we have the death workout by back. And we're doing this back workout as many reps as possible for every single movement, or as long as possible for every single movement. Now, 30 for 30 means every single morning we're coming back at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and if we don't post, it's just a rest and recovery day. So, before we jump in, I wanna give you a few tips you can be following for this workout. It's brutal, trust me, let's get to it. All right, quick tip number one. When you are doing as many reps as possible movements, I wanna make sure you are resting at least 4 to 5 minutes between sets. Number two, there is no easy way to tell you this. The reality is if you want to gain weight, you must be in a caloric surplus. If you want to lose weight, you must be in a caloric deficit. Number three, utilize your pinky in all back movements and make sure you wrap your thumb under the bar. Number four, the new Wild Blueberry Low Stim Pre-Workout launches April 27th, so stay tuned. Link is in my description. And number five and last, if you feel anxiety or stress in your life, I recommend meditating for 10 minutes after you wake up. Be intentional, start your day off strong. Okay, starting off the first set, we're gonna do as many reps as possible pull-ups. Now, with these pull-ups, it depends if you're on a door, if you're at the park, wherever you are. I just wanna make sure that your hands aren't too wide, okay? This is not a wide grip pull-up, and also that you're using your thumb and using your pinky. Squeeze as much as possible, just like the quick tips says. So, it's gonna be just outside of shoulder width apart, retracting to press your scaps, squeeze everything in, tuck in your chin, okay? Even if you wanna have your feet in front of you, almost like you're leaning, like you're about to get started as so, okay? Then you're gonna come up, and just about above your nose, or right below your nose, will be the bar, and that's pretty much it. You don't have to think too hard into these pull-ups, just don't completely remove your technique once you're like almost maxed out. Once you feel like your technique is dropping, that's when you want to stop. All right, so I have a table here and we're gonna be doing a max rep hold. So you're not really gonna be doing any reps, it's just gonna be one hold at the top for as long as you can, all right? Now, the main thing here is if you do have two bars, I would recommend doing it neutrally. I'm gonna do it here. Your grip's probably gonna be falling off like halfway through or three quarters through. But the main thing is to retract and to press those scaps as much as possible and squeeze your back as hard as you can, okay? Now, you're gonna start in this straight position. If you're a little bit more beginner, go ahead and bend your knees and put your hand or your feet into the ground, okay? Tuck in your chin, squeeze everything. Notice how I'm already loading my entire body. I'm squeezing my glutes from this position. I'm gonna come up with my hands just out of shoulder width apart here, and I'm gonna hold, all right? Now, I don't wanna be here. I wanna retract and depress and squeeze in my abs. So I'm not here, but I'm here squeezing it in, and that is your set. All right, this set we have max push away hold on the ground. Now, just to remind you, our arms are not gonna be too right by our side. It's gonna be slightly pointed outward, okay? We're gonna tuck in our stomachs as much as possible, squeezing our abs, make sure our lower back is on the ground, all right? Now from this position, all we're going to do is squeeze our necks really by tucking everything in, tightening everything in, squeezing our abs, and we're gonna come up and hold in this position. Now, I don't want you to be here. This is gonna be incorrect. And notice how my lower back is on the ground. We want the lower back to be off the ground and squeezing everything in completely straight, tucking in as much as possible, max hold. It's brutal, you got this. Okay, so TUT stands for time under tension. This is gonna be pull-ups, okay? So make sure you're coming up 8 seconds and coming down 8 seconds. Don't cheat yourself. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? Just make sure it's proper. I would even put a stopwatch in front of you or somewhere that you can see it as you're doing it, all right? So just outside of shoulder width apart, time under tension is gonna look like this. You're squeezing everything in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then coming right back up. It is absolutely brutal when you do it, and that's your set.
Okay, so we're outside right now. Just wanted to find a quick wall while I'm right by the garage. So we're gonna do a low trap drag, as many reps as possible. Now, this is going to burn like crazy, and when I say as many reps as possible, it's gonna be only until you really feel like it's burning so crazy that you want to stop, okay? So keeping your chin tucked, we wanna make sure our low back is up against the wall. If it's not up against the wall, then you are doing it incorrectly, okay? So notice how I'm not here, I'm not here. I am up against the wall, crisscross applesauce, as so big chest right here, okay? We're going to internally rotate at our shoulders, and we're gonna be coming up all the way through to above us here, and then right back down. So we're trying to stay internally rotated as much as we can. Obviously, my mobility restricts me. It will restrict you too. Nobody can do that completely, all right? Or maybe one or two people, and coming right back down. Now, we want it to be like a 3 or 4 second count going up and down. You can also use a 5 pound or a 7.5 pound weight. I generally do it with fives and sometimes even 2.5. So there you go, and that's your set.
All right, here we go. We're finishing off. You're probably destroyed at this point. I suggest using some type of a bench or something that you can utilize if you're not extremely advanced with all these pulling movements. You're going to be pretty tired at this point and fatigued. So chin up means a supinated grip. Okay, supinated is right here. We're gonna have our thumb under the bar and squeezing with our pinky. Make sure we're squeezing as hard as we can into the bar. This is gonna help utilize all the muscles. All right, now hands, they can be a little bit within shoulder width apart. I actually suggest it more than I do not. So try and do that as well, keeping everything tucked as so. It's gonna be pulling up. You don't wanna go too high. It's not what it calls for. We don't wanna start incorporating our shoulders and other muscles or joints into this that we don't necessarily have to as much, okay? So come up here, that's all you need. Right about eye level to your nose, and that's your last set.
All right, so there you have it. That is your workout for the day, 30 for 30 series, meaning every single morning, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, we come back with a new bodyweight workout for you to follow. Now give me your feedback. I'd love to hear how you felt about this workout. If you are not crazy advanced and used to doing these types of workout stuff, I suggest drinking a lot of water, hydrate a lot, rest up, do a little bit of stretching, eat a lot of nutrient-dense foods, and that's like fruits, vegetables, high quality proteins. Don't miss out on your carbs either. Remember, carbohydrates are incredible for energy. I have a lot myself. And yeah, if you have any questions, go ahead and DM me on Instagram at TheBMyers right here. Follow me whenever you want. We also post these workouts to Facebook as well, so you can go over there if you ever want to. Create Nutrition, the new low stim pre-workout is launching April 27th. I am hyped about this, so hyped. Monday at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. The link will be in the description, or it's gonna be at createyounutrition.com. So make sure you prepare yourself. It's gonna be a blast to launch this product. Anyways, I'm Brendan. This is my YouTube channel. I also have a podcast, if you didn't know, Create You Experience. And I'll see you next time. Peace. We'll be right back.